to LA, yeah. Finally in LA, yeah. Looking for the weed though, trying to make my own though. Calling for Maria, lost without Maria. By diving a marina. Trust me, baby, trust me. Trust me, baby, trust me. Trust me, baby, trust me. I don't mind. Trust me, baby, trust me. Trust me.
What is up? What is up? It's DJ Young Kluda definitely in the building, man. What is going on, man? So listen, on this show, we're going to cover the Stop Dating Guys list. There was a Stop Dating Guys list that was released that I saw on my timeline. So definitely we're going to get into the mix. We're going to cover the Stop Dating Guys list. So this is going to be pretty interesting, man. Let's get into the mix.
No. Call your friends, let's get drunk. Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Call your friends, let's get drunk. Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Call your friends, let's get drunk. Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Us in a day. I've been drinking all day. I've been floating all day. Bring your ass over here now. You know what? How I stay. I've been gone for some time now. I just want a little taste. Mix, mix, go. Come on over, get drunk.
Damn girl, I'll be up late. If you want, you can meet me at the studio.
Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Yeah, I've been drinking all night. Take a shot, homie, got it down, Julio.
Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Yeah, I'm guessing this is new to you. Thinking about all the things that I would do to you. Them lips on fire and them hips don't lie. Girl, I just wanna see what that booty do. Let's lose each other's mind. Let's make each other's night. Take advantage of time while we both intertwine. Girl, I want you on the rocks, no chaser. You should have drank it all, won't waste ya. I know you stay sober. I'm sure a few drinks won't faze ya.
Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Hello.
Call your friends, let's get drunk.
Let's get drunk.
All right, man, let's get into it. Let's get into it, man.
We're going to go over the Stop Dating Guys list. This is a list that is out here, you know, because you know what's funny? Hold on. Let's get into it. Hold on. Okay. We over here chilling at Player Talk Radio. So listen, you know what is pretty funny? You know, these memes and stuff, they get released on like Facebook and like other, you know, websites like, you know, Instagram and, you know, Twitter, and you know, people are a bit dumb. And you know, memes, you know, was really not talked about. Memes actually control what's going on in these dating games. Like, people be taking memes, you know, there's a comedic value behind a lot of memes, and then there's deep value behind a lot of memes. But have you noticed, like, nowadays, especially in the dating scene, memes have become a source of news to people and guidelines and stuff. Because certain memes that you share and things that you do with memes, you actually agree with. So, there's a Stop Dating Guys meme that's out here. And it says, it has some good ones on there, and it has some other ones on there too. So, this is going to be for ladies and this is going to be for guys, because you, both of you guys need to stop bullshitting. There's a lot of fake shit going on in this dating game, and for you to properly date in this climate, you guys need to know when to dispel stuff. Fellas, you need to know anything women say to you or anything, you know, that they do, you need to take it with a grain of salt. You have to take everything they do with a grain of salt. So if she says, listen, I'm single, but I'm not looking. You know, broads just say shit like that just because they, sometimes they just don't want to deal with, you know, a certain conversation. They're probably not attracted to you, or they just bullshitting. A lot of broads just, shit just rolls off their tongue. You dig what I'm saying? So that doesn't necessarily mean that's true. Look at your girlfriend, for example. If you have a girlfriend, a lot of times she probably was off that same shit. Like, I'm single. I just got out of a relationship. I just don't. You know, every broad says that at some point. Bitches say that shit on a date. If you're really not looking for that, why are you on a date? Anywho, I'm getting off topic. But we're going to go over this list. And we're going to dispel shit that's on this list. So, let me switch it up for y'all for one second, man. What's going on today? It's a Sunday, man. I've been getting shit ready. So, this show is going to be vicious, man. We're going to do a show tomorrow, man. And I'm going to have female co-host, or maybe female co-hosts. Funny thing, the word female is on this list. Alright, so are you guys ready to go over this list? Because I definitely am. So let me get a nice fucking beat that I can spit this list over to. Let's see what type of mood I'm feeling right now. Oh, we can do some. Bad emoji. Alright, so let's go over this list. Let me stop playing around with y'all. Alright, so listen. Number one. No, I'm not gonna do the numbers because my ass is gonna. Number one. Stop dating guys who ask about your body count. Now, can't that count as like a health question? Like, stop dating guys who ask about your body count. Shouldn't a guy kind of know what he's dealing with? I mean, you're not gonna answer truthfully. I mean, I've been around the block, up the road, all that shit. Listen, fellas, if you ask a female what's her body count, she's not gonna answer truthfully. Anytime she tells you a number, you need to add 5 more counts to it. So she said, oh, I only messed with 5 guys. She messed with 10. Maybe 15. But she messed with 10. I'm telling you. She messed with 10. Women like to do things where they don't count one night stands as, you know, guys they've been with. They're not going to count them shits. Women don't count one night stands. Unless it was a bomb one night stand or went down crazy. Women do not count one night stands. Trust me on this, niggas. I'm telling you the truth, okay? Stop dating guys who refer to women as females. Funny thing is, women always date guys who refer to them as females. The connotation behind this stop dating is a guy that refers to women as females looks at you guys as objects, or they, you know, they objectify you, or, you know, you're just a broad. You know, broad is another word. Stop dating guys that refer to women as broads. The thing is, this is a guy that's dealt with a lot of women, because women on general deal with a lot of guys, so she connects more with this type of guy because there's he knows how to correctly deal with a girl like her. I'm telling you, this is how shit goes. And when he knows how to, and she knows that he knows how to correctly deal with a girl like her, they say to stop dating guys that refer to women as females. In a way, women know they deal with a lot of guys on a daily basis, so they short themselves when they actually do this, and then they get a guy that has a veil over his eyes and that's cloaked about shit that they do. Then they get mad and frustrated in the relationship because, or if they get with a guy or when they're in the presence of a guy like that, because he doesn't pick up on certain things. She gets more frustrated because he can't understand certain things about her that she feels a man needs to understand. Because in a relationship like that, you know, they still lose sight of what they did to get you. And they realize that they're a woman and they look to men for certain things. And when they look to this certain guy that they choose, those things aren't going to be there. Oh, I'm breaking this shit down. So listen, stop dating guys who fat shame. Listen, there's a lot of guys out here that like big women, so I can't really touch on that just yet. I can only speak for myself because I got standards. But a nigga out here with standards, that's terrible. To a lot of people, like, you know, you were to tell somebody you got standards and you really break it down, you know, as a guy, you know you're not supposed to have standards, right? That's why a lot of guys out here are walking around without standards. So. Anywho, but shit, ain't nothing wrong with no big girl shit. Anywho, certain ones though, there's a borderline, certain ones. All right, so stop dating guys who don't eat pussy. Look, I agree with that wholeheartedly, but don't just date a guy that just eats any pussy. Not every dude knows how to eat pussy and at the same time. You just don't want to know. Man. That goes both ways. But I agree. Don't take guys that who eat pussy. Them religious niggas, they be sneaking that shit in too. So, anywho. Stop dating guys who don't listen when you speak. Okay. See, a lot of this shit, how do you know if he's listening or not? Because a guy can look like he's not listening and he's actually listening. And a lot of times, a lot of females, you do date guys who don't listen when you speak. Because when you with somebody and they don't listen and you're interested in them, you're the fact that you're interested in them will make you stick around and keep talking to them to make sure they listen. Alright, so listen to this one. Stop dating guys who expect boyfriend favors with no commitment. I agree and then I don't agree. Because ladies, you have to be doing stuff to show that you're girlfriend material.